Hey guys, I wanted to share with you a few things that you can find in Windows 7 that are pretty cool. If you're thinking about switching over from XP or from Vista, here's some things that you can expect to find in Windows 7. To pin a program or shortcut to the taskbar or the start menu. To pin something to the start menu or the taskbar, you can see that there's different programs already down at the bottom, and you'll have programs that are open appear down here as well. If you want to have something as a shortcut on the taskbar, you can right click on any program and choose pin to taskbar, and the same thing if you want it to be on the start menu. You just right click on it and choose that option, and you'll see on the bottom that there the program is. If you want to remove it, right click on it, and then you can choose to unpin this program from the taskbar. Same thing with the start menu. If you right click on it and choose to pin to the start menu, it'll be up here, and then if you right click on it, you can unpin it from the start menu, or you can leave it there and pin it to the taskbar as well. Another really cool feature I like is the option when you hover over documents or programs that are already open on your taskbar, and you get an actual preview of them. Check it out. Hovering over the taskbar, you can hover over any program that's open and you'll get previews of the different programs there. Another cool feature is now if you hover over that small preview to see something of those little programs, you can hover over any one of those small previews and it gives you the big preview on your screen. Now I'm not clicking on them, I'm just hovering over top. Once you hover off, the window disappears. So I hover over top of the icon, hover over top of the small preview, and then click on that if I want that to be the program that I want access to. Something else I like is the AltTab that you're used to in XP. Now some people may not even have known to this day now, that you may be learning for the first time, that you can toggle between programs by doing Alt and Tab. Hold down the Alt key and press Tab, and it will toggle between the various applications you have open. It looks really cool now here the way we have it, plus some other cool option you'll see here. Switching between the different applications is a lot easier, and a lot of people have still never used it in previous versions of Windows, and if you haven't, you're missing out on a tool that can allow you to quickly switch between applications. Instead of moving your mouse constantly back down to the taskbar, you can hold down the Alt key on your keyboard and press Tab, and you get a window come up similar to this one. Now in XP it was a lot more plain. In 7 it's got this fancy look to it, and as I hold down the Alt key and keep pressing Tab, it highlights the different programs and brings a preview of them in front. When I let go of Alt, there I am and I have that program in front of me. A cool way of doing this with Windows 7 now is holding down the Windows key and doing Tab. If you don't know what the Windows key is, it's in between your Control and Alt Tab, or your Control key and your Alt key normally on your keyboard. Your keyboards may vary, but it's a key that has a picture of a window on it. It's the Microsoft Windows symbol. Hold down that key, press Tab, and you get something like this. Searching is done a lot different now than it was in XP. Vista has been doing it the same as Windows 7, or I should say Windows 7 does it the same as Vista was, but if you're coming from XP, you used to go through your start menu and hit search. It's a lot better. Here in Vista or Windows 7, you click on the Perl and you can just start typing in what it is you're looking for. It'll give you the name of the file. For example, I typed in test, so I have some documents that have the word test as part of the name of the document. It found a program, OneNote, that has the word test somewhere within that document. It's found some emails that have the word test within that email somewhere, and then some other files that have the word test within that. where's all your programs and how to access them in the documents. I'm going to show you where things are, just a quick overview. Accessing programs is through the Start Perl, and you'll have the main programs that you normally use available right here. If you go down to All Programs, you can click on it or just wait for a few seconds, and then it brings up the list of all the programs that you have. You can click on any one of those folders to see the list of all the other programs within that folder. The other files that you'd have would be your main personal folder, which also will store your documents, pictures, music. You've got My Computer, which you should already know from XP what that is. It's the same, holding your C drive and your DVDs. The control panel, where you can make customized settings to your computer, printers, etc. From Windows Vista, the button here was to snooze or sleep the computer. You'd have to click the arrow to go to shutdown. They've corrected that now in Windows 7, so it's a lot easier to identify the shutdown. Some of the different programs I'd like to go through is pretty cool in Vista or Windows 7 here. Sticky notes. If you go up there to choose sticky notes, you'll have this notepad come up and you can type in your note. You can leave that note there and put it anywhere on your desktop that you want, and you can have other windows up on top of that. Once you close that window, at the end of the day, you close all the programs and there's your sticky note you have. The snipping tool is something that only Mac had something like this built in for the longest time, and there, although there's other programs that you could download, Windows 7 now has a program that comes with the computer. Click on the snipping tool and it brings up this little window. It's ready to take a snapshot of a part of your computer. So if you have an error message you'd like to take a screenshot of, so you can take that for your technician, you just click and drag and then let go of the mouse button, and there you go, you've now got a screenshot, and you can save it, copy it, paste it into a document, email it directly from here, and you can even mark it up with some pen or highlighter in that before you save it and send it. The gadgets that come with Windows 7 are a lot different now. You can right click on your desktop and choose gadgets, and you have the same gadgets basically, but when you grab one to put on your desktop, you can close out of here, it doesn't have to be on the far right side like it's always been. You can now move it anywhere on your computer. Windows 7 Paint program looks a little more sleek. You can go into View and turn on and off the ruler or the grid lines if you want to make more fine type work. And they've got quite a few different brushes, brush types available to do some pretty cool looking artwork. You got highlighters, finger paints, pencil crayons. You got your shapes. One of the other things here is choosing the secondary color. Now, in XP it used to be that you'd right click on the secondary color to have that choose your second color. Here you would click on color 2, click on what the color will be, and now you can choose to do a design, and it's going to have your primary and secondary colors.